हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन. होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग गुड. वेलकम टू बीएमसी एजु इंग्लिश स्टैंडर्ड 4. माई सेल्फ शेख फरहाना बानू. सो टुडे वी विल स्टडी द सब्जेक्ट इज ईवीएस 2. ओके, चिल्ड्रन, डोंट फॉरगेट टू सब्सक्राइब, लाइक एंड शेयर आर बीएमसी एजु इंग्लिश स्टैंडर्ड 4. ओके, सो टुडे वी विल सी लेसन नंबर 18 ऑफ योर ईवीएस 2, मैनेजमेंट ऑफ द वेलफेयर स्टेट ऑफ स्वराज. सो टुडे वी विल सी हाउ शिवाजी महाराज, सी वी हैव लर्नड अबाउट हाउ शिवाजी महाराज हैड स्ट्रगल फॉर द स्वराज. ओके, सो हाउ डिड ही मैनेज, ओके हाउ डिड ही मैनेज इट्स हिज वेलफेयर स्टेट, ओके आफ्टर गेटिंग द स्वराज. सी वी ऑल नो चिल्ड्रन दैट शिवाजी महाराज ही हैड स्ट्रगल्ड अ लॉट, ओके अगेंस्ट मेनी अनजस्ट पावर्स. देर वर मेनी अनजस्ट पावर्स हु वर इन इंडिया. ओके, सो शिवाजी महाराज ही स्ट्रगल्ड, ही फॉट विद देम, ओके To achieve the Swaraj. So we all know who all were there. We'll see. See, Siddhis of Janjira. Okay, the unjust powers who were ruling in India. Okay, Siddhis of Janjira and Adil Shahi. Adil Shahis were there. Adil Shahs. And Portuguese, even the Portuguese were there. And the Mughals. Mughals were there. So, children, Adil Shahi, Mughal power, Portuguese, and Siddhis of Janjira, these were the unjust power. They were ruling in India. So, our hero, the Shivaji Maharaj, he got the Swaraj and he established the independent Hindavi Swaraj in, was created, okay, by Shivaji Maharaj. So he fought with all of them. So for that, after achieving the Swaraj, okay, for managing the welfare state of the Swaraj, so what he did, Shivaji Maharaj, for smooth working of the administration, so what he did, he made departments, okay, the Council of Eight Ministers, So he appointed eight ministers and he gave them their post. Okay, according to the ministers, he gave them their post. Okay, we'll see them. So the first department was, of administration. Okay, the designation, okay, the post was Pradhan. And his name, the name of the minister was Moro Trimbak Pingle. So Moro Trimbak Pingle, his designation was Pradhan and his department was administration, means political work. What all political work was there? The Pradhan used to do that. Next, it was about, next was Ramachandran, Ramachandra Nilkanth Muzumdar. Okay, he was Amatya. What was he? Amatya. Amatya means his department was revenue and accounts of the state. Whatever money, okay, accounts, it is related with the money, finance. So he handles all the thing. Okay, he was Amatya. His designation name was Amatya. Next. Now, as you can see here, there is swords and swords are there. Okay, so in this, the name of the minister was Hambir Rao. Hambir Rao Mohite. His name was Hambir Rao Mohite and his designation was Senapati. He was Senapati. So, the department related to the defense. Okay, related to the army. As you can see here, arms and ammunition are there. Okay, so it is related with the defense. So, he takes care of it. Whatever new arms are needed, okay, if old, if the arms are old, we need to renew them, okay, we need to polish them, or anything is to be done. So everything he is taking care of it. So he's the Senapati. What is he? Senapati or defense department. Next was, as you can see here, the temple. Okay, so his name was Moreshwar Pandit Rao. What was his name? Moreshwar Pandit Rao. And he is, his designation, his post, his designation is Pandit Rao. His designation is Pandit Rao. And his department is religious matter. Whenever Shivaji Maharaj won any battle, okay, whatever the puja is to be conducted, okay, so everything he deals with that, he takes care of it, okay, all the religious matter, who deals it? Pandit Rao. Designation is Pandit Rao. Next is, his name was Niraji Ravaji. His name was Niraji Ravaji. And his designation is Nyayadish. Nyayadish means justice. His department is justice. Okay. We all know for the, getting the justice, we go to the court. Okay. Same way, he is the Nyayadish. So he deals with the justice. Whatever problems are there, first he deals with that. If it is too much, then it goes to the Shivaji Maharaj. Okay. So he is the Nyayadish. Next is, his name was Annaji Datto. His name was Annaji Datto. And his designation, his post is Sachiv. His post is Sachiv. And he deals with the government order. Department is government orders. Whatever orders are given, okay, by the government, he is taking care of it. So he is Sachiv. He is Sachiv. Next, seventh one is Mantri. Okay. His name was Dattaji Trimbak Vaknis. Okay. Dattaji Trimbak Vaknis. He is the Mantri. Correspondence. Okay. He is a Mantri. He is correspondence. He connect with the Shivaji Maharaj. Okay. He is a Mantri. Next. Last. Eighth one is Ramchandra Trimbak Dabir. Ramchandra Trimbak Dabir. He is a Sumant. His designation name is Sumant. And he deals with the foreign relations. Whatever trade or business is to be done with the foreign countries, he takes care of it. So he is Sumant. He deals with the foreign relations. Okay. So all these children, eight ministers were appointed. Okay, eight ministers were appointed. We all know Pradhan, Amatya, Sachiv, Mantri, Senapati, Sumant, Pandit Rao, Nyayadish. So all eight of them, okay, are important officers. Okay, they are appointed by Shivaji Maharaj himself. Okay, according to their eligibility and merit. Okay, they are appointed, and to help them, okay, to help them, other officers were also appointed, because only from with them, it is not possible to handle the whole Swaraj. Okay, so other ministers were also appointed, and they were also appointed by Shivaji Maharaj, and on the basis of their eligibility and merit, their capability, they are able to do or not, according to their capability, Shivaji Maharaj appointed them. And Shivaji Maharaj, he supervised them. He checks whether the mantris, whether the ministers are working properly or not. If they are not working properly, if the people of Shivaji Maharaj, they have complained about them, so he will punish them also. Okay, it is not that key, they are ministers, they will not be punished. Okay, Shivaji Maharaj punished them also, because he only follows the justice. Okay, so these are the eight ministers. The council of eight ministers was established by Shivaji Maharaj. Okay, for the smooth running of his administration. frustration. Now let's see next. See, people live happily in Swaraj. Okay, in a state of Swaraj, people they live happily, created by Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. Therefore, the qualities of confidence. See, they are living in the Swaraj, they are free. So what thing is developed in the people? They are confidence. Okay, self-respect. They have respect for themselves. Okay, and patriotism means love towards the country. Okay, strongly emerged among the people of the Maharashtra. Okay, this was there in them. Now let's see. Protection of environment. Okay, now children, you have to tell me what all comes in the environment. Okay, natural environment. Now, you can see from the picture and you can tell me. Okay, come on, tell me, what do you see in the picture? It is related to the environment, natural environment. Can you tell me? Yes.
It's animals, birds, okay. Trees.
Birds and animals, trees, and what else are there? Birds are rivers. There, animals, very
rivers.
Good. Rivers. Yes? Rivers, very good. And plants and forest is there. Rivers, a river is there. Air is there. Okay. So, air, water, forest, birds, and animals. All these things are the environmental factors. They are related with the nature. So, Shivaji Maharaj, for protection of environment, Shivaji Maharaj, he took care of all these things. He took care of all these things because air, water, forest, birds, and animals, if they are protected, children, if they are protected, only man can live properly. Okay. And man use the environment only to meet his necessities. Okay, so Shivaji Maharaj, he took great care of it, all these things. Okay, let's see now. Now, see here, children, when Shivaji Maharaj, you can see here, this is a boat, okay, and this is oar. This is called oars. Okay, this is called oars. Okay, so boats and oars and masts. This is mats. You can see here. Okay, this is mats. Masts. Okay, so for this, you can tell me, can you tell me from what the boat is made up of? You can see the boat over here in this picture, children. Can you tell me with what it is made?
With trees, cutting down the
from
trees.
From the?
Trees.
From cutting down the trees, we will get the wood. We will get the wood, and after we use the wood in making the boat. So children, in Shivaji Maharaj time, the protection of environment was taken care. So wood was used for making the boats. So what was the rule of Shivaji Maharaj, children? What was his rule? He told him for this, for making, using the wood in making the boats, oars, and mast. You can see here, for making the mast, the wood is used. Okay. So which wood is used? Teak wood is used. Which wood is used? Teak wood was used. And he has, yes, teak wood was used. And he has told his people. What he had told his people? He had strictly told them. What did he told? He told them not to use the wood of the trees of mango trees and jackfruit trees. Children, see, he told them to use the wood of the teakwood trees, and not to use mango trees and jackfruit trees, because they give these trees, they should not be cut down. Okay, and because they don't grow early. See, if more teak wood and more teak wood trees are required, okay, it should be purchased from foreign countries. For example, if they are making the boats and oars, okay, they need more and more. They need the teak wood. So for that, what did he told them? He told his people to purchase, means to buy it from the foreign territories. Okay. But on no account, trees should be cut. Okay. Trees should not be cut. They don't grow in a year or two. okay, because people look after them like their own children in order to grow them. Okay, what people do, we grow the trees with so much of love and care. We water them, okay, we take care of them. Okay, so the people, they grow the trees like their own children. So this was taken care by Shivaji Maharaj. So he told them not to use the trees of mango or jackfruit or other fruits trees. Okay, but to take the wood from the teak wood. Okay, now see, even when a tree is greatly worn out, with the condition of the tree is not so good. Okay, it is worn out. It should be cut only after paying the owner and getting his consent. Okay, when the tree is like it is falling down anytime, so you should take the permission of the owner of the tree, and we have to pay them. Okay, we need your tree, we need your wood, tree's wood, and we are paying you. So this was the rule of Shivaji Maharaj. So you can see here, from this rule we can come to know he thinks a lot about his people, okay, about his subjects and about the nature as well. Okay, now next is water management. Let's see what was the water management of Shivaji Maharaj. See, what he had done, canals were dug out to make water available for agriculture. You can see here, in this way the canals were dug, okay, so that they can get the water for agriculture. Now, Shivaji Maharaj had various bunds. Okay, he had built various bunds, lakes, rivers were there, okay, built near the villages in Swaraj, okay, to make drinking water available to the people. What he did, he built bunds, okay, near the villages so that people can get the proper amount of drinking water. Now, this is a picture of a drought. It means, okay, we'll see. People in Swaraj never felt the severity of drought. See here, it means his water management was so good. His water management was so good that the people, they never felt the severity, okay, severe condition. They never felt the severe condition of drought. You can see here, this is a picture of a drought. It means that the people, they never face problem of water. During Shivaji Maharaj time, the number of people living on forts was quite large. See, there were too many people, okay? The number of people were more, okay? So the people where they live, they also live on the forts, okay? Beta, mute your mic. They live on the forts. Okay, it was quite large. The population was quite large. So he took care to make proper arrangements for water on the forts. You can see here. So it is very difficult to get the water on the forts. People have to carry from down here. They have to carry the water on the forts. So it is very difficult for them. So for them also, Shivaji Maharaj had made arrangement. Okay, as the population, as the number of people were quite large, okay, number of people were quite large, so the people, they live in the forts as well, okay. So the water, so what water facility Shivaji Maharaj provided them, let's see. In case the fort didn't have water, see, if there is no water on the fort, so tanks and reservoirs were built there. You can see your tanks were built, okay, and reservoirs were there before the onset of the rainy season, and rainwater was stored in them. So before the rainy season comes, so what Shivaji Maharaj did, there were tanks were built, okay, and reservoirs were made so that people living near the fort or people living in the fort, they can use this water. Okay, so there won't be shortage of water for them as well. See, so smart, and he's thinking about ahead. Now, due to such water management, people on the forts and other subjects in Swaraj did not suffer from shortage of water even during drought periods. See, when it was a drought period in other places, but in Shivaji's, in Swaraj, okay, the people, they did not face this problem because Shivaji Maharaj already planned for it. Okay, he had already planned for the future, how to save the water for the subjects. Now, drought relief. Let's see what is drought. Okay, we are talking about drought, but what it is? See, drought is a continuous period of dry weather. Dry, okay. The weather is dry. When an area gets less than its normal amount of rain, over months or even year, when that particular place there is no rain, okay, there is no rain over months and even year, so that place, if there is no water, what happened to the land? The land will become dry, okay, and the weather will also become dry. So continuous period of dry weather, okay, dry weather, that causes drought, that causes drought. So what Shivaji Maharaj, if in case there is drought in the Swaraj of Shivaji Maharaj, in his state, if there is drought, what relief? Okay, relief means for the people, what he had done for the people. Let's see that, okay. See, Shivaji Maharaj distributed the grain stored in the state granaries free of cost to the people. Now what happens? See, in the state granaries, see, this is a granary, okay, a big place where, see, this is a granary, a big place where sacks of grains are kept, that is called granaries. So in the state granaries, it is of the state. So what he does, he gives it to the people, okay, because of drought there is no agriculture. So what the people will eat? So for the people, it is given free of cost. It doesn't take any money from the people. It is distributed to the people free, okay, during the drought times. And he also undertook repairs of various forts and construction of dams, bunds and canals during drought years. What he does, he starts repairing his forts, okay, dams, bunds and canals. Why he start repairing? This way, peasants means farmers and artisans or balutedars could earn their daily living, okay, because there is no water, so no agriculture. So what the people will do? Okay, what the people will do? So to get the money, to earn the money, Shivaji Maharaj did not to give them free. See, if they will work, they will work on the forts, for the forts, construction of dams, bunds and canals. So in this way, they will earn their daily living and did not feel the severity of drought. Okay, as the peasant became wealthy, and the peasant will become wealthy, if they will earn, they will work for Shivaji Maharaj, they will get money. Okay, and they will become wealthy. He could afford to buy things like, so what the farmer will do? See, he is working for Shivaji Maharaj and then he will get the money from there. And what he will do? And he will buy. What he will buy? Things like footwear, clothes, etc. From where he will buy? See, he will buy pots from the potter. Okay, see, for constructing the forts, okay, for repairing the forts, Shivaji Maharaj also need bricks, okay. So the brick makers, he will also get money, he will also earn, okay. The cobblers and the masons here and the carpenters, all of them will also get the money. So in this way, the artisans, the work, the people who are doing work, the arts, okay, the artisans also became happy and wealthy because even they are earning, okay, they could sell their things. So in this way, children, indirect way, Shivaji Maharaj is helping all of them. See, you can see here, Shivaji Maharaj distributing the clothes to the needy people. Okay. See here. So in this way, Shivaji Maharaj helped the people. Now, next is sea trade and other markets. Okay, let's see here. What is it? Children, remember, na? Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. Okay, Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj was called the father of the Indian Navy. Father of the Indian Navy. Okay, it is related to the sea. Okay, we protect our place near the sea coast area. Okay, through the Navy. The Navy people, they protect it. Okay, when Shivaji Maharaj, he is called the father of the Indian Navy. Okay, let's see. He is called the father of the Indian Navy. Who? Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. Children, remember, don't forget this. Now see, Shivaji Maharaj had special cargo ships. Okay, big ships were built to promote trade in Swaraj. Means trade, means to do business, to do business in Swaraj. He developed trade ports like Rajapur and built a special market on Raigad. He started a special market place at Khed, Shivapur, near Pune. See what he did? He started cargo ships, okay, to promote the trade, means to buy the things, okay, to import and export, okay, to import and export through ships. So he started, that is why he's called the father of the Indian Navy. So in his Swaraj, okay, he developed trade ports, means a place like at Rajapur, and he also built special market. Okay, he built the market so that people can go there and sell the products. Now, he levied more taxes. See, he levied, he demand. Okay, levied means demand. He demand more taxes on goods and salt imported from the outside regions to promote trade within Swaraj. See, whatever the things, okay, for the business, the things which is imported from the outside regions, like goods, okay, whatever goods and salt, these were the main, salt and goods, they are imported from outside region. So what Shivaji Maharaj did, he demand for more taxes on them. What he did, he took more taxes from them. Because they are importing, they are bringing the things from outside region. Okay, and what he did on the other hand, he reduced the tax. What he did, he reduced the tax on the salt produced in Swaraj. Means we are growing it, we are producing it. So he has reduced the tax on the people so that people could buy it at a cheaper rate. Naturally, it led to an increase in the local trade of salt and other goods. So what the people do, people will do, they will not, because they will buy the things which is here, which is produced in Swaraj itself. Okay, because its rates are cheaper than which is imported. So in this way, the local trade means our Swaraj trade. Okay. Trade of salt and other goods will increase. Now, high regard for women. Let's see what was his view about women. He always respect women. See, Shivaji Maharaj had ordered that the women and children in the enemy camp were not to be harmed in any way during the period of war. See what he did, when they go for the war, the army officers, the army people, they should not harm the women and children, okay, during the period of war. In fact, they were to be treated with great respect. If they are going to fight with somebody, with the enemy. Okay. If there are small children are there and ladies are there, women are there, so the army officers, they should not harm them, but they should treat with them with great respect. Okay. This was the rule of Shivaji Maharaj. Okay. He always respect women and children. Same way we will see about, see, this is a picture of a lady. You can see her, she's standing and he is Shivaji Maharaj. Shivaji Maharaj honors Malamma Desai. Who is she? Malamma Desai of Belawadi. She is from Belawadi. Okay, we will see about her. What's her name, children? Repeat after me. Malamma Desai. Come on. Malamma. Yes. Children, repeat after me. Malamma Desai.
Malamma Desai.
Very good. What was her name? Malamma Desai. Okay. She was from Belawadi. Okay. We'll see about her. See, Belawadi, Malamma. The Maratha army had marched upon Belawadi in Karnataka. So where did they march? At the place of Belawadi in Karnataka. And Malamma Desai was from there to vanquish the fortress there. Okay. A brave woman. What was her name? A brave woman. Malamma Desai. She fought a great battle in defense of the fortress. Okay. She is protecting her fortress. Okay. Her village. And she is a brave woman and she is fighting with the Maratha army. When Shivaji Maharaj came to know about her courage, when he came to know she is a lady and she is fighting so bravely, he called her his younger sister. He told that she is my younger sister. She is so brave. And he returned her fortress and villages with honor and gave her the title Savitri. He told them she is a Savitri and she is a brave woman, Malamma Desai. And he returned to her fortress and villages to her. Okay. And he gave her the title called Savitri. Okay. She was given the title of Savitri. What was her name? Malamma Desai. See, vigilance regarding cleanliness. Let's see about the cleanliness during Shivaji time. Now, children, Nirgudi bush. Okay, this is a small bush. What Shivaji Maharaj had told? He told the people to make a fence. Okay, in this way, make a fence of the Nirgudi bush around the house to prevent the entry of animals like mice, scorpions, insects, and ants. Okay. And so that fumigation was also suggested to destroy the germs that are harmful to health. Now what he did, he told the people to make a fence in this way around the house and which will protect their house from the entry of the mice, scorpion, insects and ants. If they will come inside the house and they will cause diseases and germs, okay? So in this way, he told them to fence a Nirgudi bush around the house to protect themselves. Okay, so let's see. Now see, and what about the garbage? See, we dispose the garbage. Okay, so what was at that time? Okay, what was at that time during Shivaji Maharaj? So what he did? See. Piles of garbage. Okay. Piles was garbage. Okay. If it is found near the roads and market city. Okay. On the fort. Okay. So what the pile of garbage, it was made and it was burned. What it was burned? It was burned on the spot. Wherever it was found, it was burned on the spot. And afterwards, after burning the garbage, Okay, in the last we get the ash. Okay, we get the ash of the garbage. Sorry, we get the ash of the garbage. What is done of that? So ashes used as manure for vegetables grown in backyards. Okay, for growing the vegetables as a manure, it is used, the ashes. See, piles of garbage, if it is formed, so how he, what he did? He did not allow. See, for the cleanliness, he's thinking so much. He burned them. He told the people to burn them on the spot and use the ash as a manure. Okay, so in this way, the public hygiene, okay, cleanliness and hygiene is made. Okay, even today we use all these things, his methods for cleanliness. Children, Hindavi Swaraj. We all know Swaraj. Okay, now what is Hindavi Swaraj? Let's see. Hindavi Swaraj was a dream of Shivaji Maharaj. Okay, it is a dream of Shivaji Maharaj. Anyone who lives in Hindustan, no matter to what religion or community they belong, was a Hindavi. Okay, so it means that anyone who lives in Hindustan, in our country, so no matter to the religion, children, see, he is specifying the religion and community. No matter you are living in Hindustan, in India, so you are a Hindavi Swaraj. And their Raj, rule was Hindavi Swaraj. Okay, for the people. Okay, for the people, they live in Hindustan. Okay, and it is their Raj. So that is why. The Hindavi Swaraj, so the people, they in the beginning of the lesson we had seen, they have self-respect, they have patriotism, they have confidence, because they are living in the Hindavi Swaraj. It is their place, it is their state. Okay, now let's see religious tolerance. What is religious tolerance? Shivaji Maharaj never caused any harm. Okay, he never caused any harm to mosque. If he came across a copy of the Quran Sharif, he would respectfully pass it on to the Muslims. See, whenever they go for the war in other place, okay? So if they found any religious things, if they find, so they return it to that religion person. See, once he found, see, if he found the Quran Sharif, it is returned to the Muslim, and he never harms mosque. Okay, mosque means masjids. Okay, and he never caused harm to them. Now, if a person who had changed his religion wished to return to his original religion, Shivaji always helped him. His brother-in-law, Bajaji Naik Nimbalkar, was in the service of Adil Shah of Bijapur. We had seen about Adil Shah, okay? Even Shivaji Maharaj fought with Adil Shah. So Bajaji Naik Nimbalkar, he is the brother-in-law of Shivaji Maharaj. He was in the service. He worked for Adil Shah, okay, of Bijapur. Adil Shah made him accept the Muslim faith. Okay, Adil Shah told Bajaji to accept the Muslim faith. Bajaji made Bijapur his home. And Bajaji, he lived in Bijapur only, along with Adil Shah. But Bajaji was unhappy that he had changed his religion. So one day, he made up his mind to come back to his own religion. And Shivaji welcomed him. So Adil Shah, what he did? Forcefully, he told Bajaji to change his religion. And Bajaji was not happy with that. So one day Bajaji, he himself went to Shivaji, and Shivaji welcomed him, and Bajaji came back to his religion. Similarly was the story of Netoji Palkar children. So Netoji Palkar was also worked for Adil Shah, and it was the same case. So even he came to Shivaji and he came back to his own religion. So in this way. See, We all know Shivaji Maharaj, children. Okay. After looking at his picture, children, look here. Huh? So studying about Shivaji Maharaj in standard 4, the whole history. Okay. What qualities do you think he possesses? He is having. Can anybody tell me? After looking at Shivaji, his bravery, what all work he has done. Can you tell me some qualities? Can you tell me? After looking at Shivaji, look at him. He's Shivaji. He's a great what? Can you tell me? Okay. Yes.
He is great king of Maharashtra.
Very good. He is a great king of Maharashtra. And what he did for the people?
He always respects women.
Very good. He respected the women. Okay. And see here. He was a great warrior. He was a great warrior. Yes.
He do not make difference between any religion.
Very good. He did not make any difference between religion. He always thought all are equal. Okay. Irrespective of their religion. Very good. He was a skilled organizer. He organized the thing skillfully. We had seen, for the drought period, before the rainy season, he planned for the people. We had seen in this lesson, okay, for the rainy season, he had planned for everything. So he thinks about the future, okay, and future that also for the people, okay, and even for the forest. For forest also, he did not allow people, he did not allow the subjects to cut down the fruit trees. Okay. So in this way, he thinks about the future. He was a fighter. Okay. He was a clever military strategist. Because his warfare, we all know. And he fought with powerful army, powerful enemies. Adil Shah, Mughals, we had seen Siddhis, Portuguese. He fought with everyone. He was the alone along with his army. A terror. He was a terror to the wicked, to the bad people. Okay, he was a terror. Terror for them. Cautious leader. Okay, he was always cautious that his people, his subjects should not get affected.
The protector of women.
Very good. He was the protector of women as well. Very good. A benevolent administrator. He was loved. Okay. He was loved by his subjects. A model son. He was a model son. He always respected his mother. Do you remember his mother's name?
Yes. Jijabai. Yes.
Very good. Jijabai. Jijamata. Okay. She was his mother. He was a model son for him, for her. Okay. So children, from all these things, we came to know that Shivaji Maharaj was a great king. Okay. He was a great king. And why he is a great king? Because he always thinks for the welfare of his subjects, for his people. Okay. See, bring to memory his wonderful images, children. Bring to his memory. Think about Shivaji Maharaj, okay, and remember his great achievements. We all know from the beginning of the lesson, we had seen children, so many fights, so many wars were there, okay. From the beginning of the lesson, we all know he fought with so many war and so many brave warriors. They have sacrificed their life, okay, for the Swaraj. So children, remember him. He had worked so much, okay, for the Swaraj, for the people. All right. Now children, answer me. It's time for the questions. First one. Dashwood was used to make boats, oars, masts. Which wood was used, children?
Teak wood. Teak wood.
Very good. Teak wood. Teak wood. Okay, very good. Next, there are dash council of ministers appointed by Shivaji Maharaj. How many ministers were appointed? Very good. There were 8 ministers were appointed. Very good. Shivaji Maharaj reduced the tax on the dash produced in Swaraj. What was produced in Swaraj? And the tax was not taken? Yes. For the things which was imported from outside the region, tax were on that, and he did not took tax from what was produced in the Swaraj people buy. Can anybody remember? Yes. Yes, children. There is no tax on that. Its color is white. It is white in color.
Salt.
Yes. Salt. Very good. Salt. Okay.
Salt.
Very good. Salt.
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 Okay. So there was no tax, which is the things which is produced in Swaraj. Next. Now, children, you have to guess who is it? Okay. Now, who is called the father of Indian Navy?
शिवाजी महाराज,
Yes. Full
महाराज,
name. Full name.
छत्रपति
छत्रपति
शिवाजी महाराज,
Very good. छत्रपति शिवाजी महाराज was called is called the father of Indian Navy. Very good. Now, who was honored with the title of Savitri?
मल्लम्मा देसाई.
Very good. Malala Desai was honored with the title of Savitri Devi. Okay, after looking her bravery. Very good. Next. Now, children, these are the give reasons. Okay, you have to tell me in short if you can. The people in Swaraj did not feel the severity of drought. Can anyone? The people in Swaraj did not feel the severity of drought. Okay, can anybody read it for me? Yes.
Food grains from the
Yes. Yes, any one of you?
government godowns
Go
were
down. Yes.
godowns were distributed freely among the people in the famine affected area. Famine relief works were started for the people. As a result, the subjects of the Shivaji did not suffer from famines.
Means. Okay, very good, very good. So, children, food grains from the government, we had seen in the lesson what he did. Shivaji Maharaj, he distributed food grain and that also free among the people when it was among the people where there was famine infected area. Okay, and famine relief work was started for the people. So, in this way, the subjects of Shivaji Maharaj did not suffer from famine. Very good. Next, Shivaji Maharaj honored Mallamma Desai. Okay, now who will read it for me? Yes.
Mallamma Desai put up a strong resistance against the army of Shivaji Maharaj. In the recognition of a
Where?
warlord, Shivaji Maharaj honored Mallamma Desai
Conferring.
by conferring the title of Savitri.
Very good, very good. Thank you.
Thank you,
See,
teacher.
Malam, very good. See, Shivaji Maharaj honored Mallamma Desai. We had seen he honored her. Why did he honored her? Because she put up a strong resistance against the army of Shivaji Maharaj. She fought with them bravely in recognition of her valor, her bravery. Shivaji Maharaj, he honored her by giving the title of Savitri. Okay. Now, fill in the blanks to complete the table. Now, we had seen the beginning of the lesson, name of the ministers were there, designations were there, and departments were there. So, the first name of the minister is Moro Trimbak Pingle. Can you remember what was his designation?
प्रधान
Very good. His designation was Pradhan. Okay. Pradhan, very good. And sorry. Next, Ramchandra Nilkant Mazumdar, Amatya. So, what does he handle? Amatya, his department.
Revenue of the state.
Very good. Revenue and accounts.
Revenue of the state.
Revenue and account. Okay, money. Okay, revenue and account. Next, Hambi Rao Mohite dash defense. Defense.
सेनापति.
वेरी गुड, सेनापति. सेनापति. ओके, सो इन दिस वे दे वर द दिस आर सम थ्री ministers and their designations and department we had seen. Very good. Now children, it's your homework time. Okay, what is your homework? Write the names of the 8 council of ministers appointed by Shivaji Maharaj. You can refer your history EVS2 textbook page number 70. Okay, for writing the names of the 8 council of ministers, the ministers, their designations and their department. Okay, hope you all enjoyed the lesson. Do like, share and subscribe our BMC Edu English Standard 4. Thank you, children. Bye.